Hello everyone, welcome you all. In the today's video, we are going to see about linked list concept from Java collections. So in our previous video, we have seen array list and what is array list and when we need to go for array list and what are the different operations and methods we can use with array list. So in the today's video, we'll see what is linked list and what are the different methods are available and when we need to go for array when we need to go for linked list. So we'll see that. So first of all, let us try to understand what is a linked list. So linked list is also one of the class which is implemented list interface. So for example, let's say I have a collection interface. This is a root interface for all the collections, and the collection interface is extended into three different interfaces. We have discussed this, like list interface, and we have a set interface, and we also have a queue interface. So these are the three interfaces which have extended from the collection interface. So this is a root interface. Now in the list interface, again implemented by using two classes. One is ArrayList class. This is a class, and there is one more class called LinkedList class. LinkedList class. So these are the two classes have implemented list interface. So whatever methods are available inside the list interface, the same methods are again implemented inside ArrayList and also LinkedList. But when you come to the linked list, apart from these methods, they are also implemented some more methods which are coming from the queue interface. So queue is also interface, and which is again extended into one more interface called dequeue interface. Dequeue interface. And this interface is again implemented by using linked list interface. So now the linked list is a, not an interface, which is a class. So linked list is a class which is implemented methods from the list interface as well as dequeue interface. So which is a having collection of methods which are coming from list interface and a dequeue interface. So today we are going to see what is linked list and what are the different methods are available and how we can work with those methods. All right, so before discussing the linked list, so we have seen what is an array list and how the elements are going to store, right? So if you have a duplicate elements, or if you want to store those elements in the insertion order is preserved, then we obviously go with the list. Either it can be array list or linked list. Even linked list also, we can store duplicate elements and insertion order is preserved. But what is the additional attributes we have in linked list? So when I talk about array list and linked list, so here this is we have array list, and I'll say I have linked list. So before understanding what is linked list and how to perform different operations, let us understand when we need to go for array list and when we have to go for linked list. So normally when you do some operations on the group of objects, let's say we will have insertion or a deletion, and the other operation we can do is retrieving the objects or retrieving the elements, right? Suppose if your group of objects, if you have a collections where you want to perform a frequent retrieving operations, right? More number of retrieving operations, then obviously go with the array list. So retrieving in the means we can get the elements or object from the list. So in that case, go with the array list. So why? Because in the array list, list of elements will be stored in the form of index. So index will represent each and every element in the array list. So by using just a get method, by passing index, we can get the particular object or value from the array list. So whenever you do a very frequent retrieving operations in the elements, then you can go with the array list concept. But when we should not prefer this array list, if your operations, more number of operations, if you want to do like insertion and deletion. So why we should not prefer array list if you have more number of operations like insertion and deletion means, I'll tell you one thing here. So for example, okay, let us take array list. So why we should not prefer array list if you have more number of insertion and deletion operations. So when I take array list like this, right? So we have multiple elements. So let's say here x, y, z and so on. And every index will represent, every element is representing with multiple indexes. So when I'm trying to insert a new element inside the array list, suppose I want to insert one element here. Then what happened, what about the rest of the elements here? Those elements should be moved to the next two locations like this. So shifting will be take care here, shifting will be placed. Similarly, if you want to delete this element, then rest of the elements should be shifted here, right? So whenever you do insertion and deletion, shifting will be takes place. So that is the reason performance will be more. So we have to prefer this array list whenever you do only retrieving operations. Whenever you have more number of retrievings, then you can go with the array list concept. But if you have insertion and deletion operations more, then don't prefer this array list concept. So that will cause again a lot of time. So if you want to insert a new element, the shifting will take time. It depends upon the number of elements. So for example, I have 100 elements or 100 objects in my array list. So I have inserted one element in the second position. So automatically 98 elements should be shifted to other locations. So this is a problem. So with that reason, we should not prefer the array list concept whenever you have more number of insertion and deletions. But you can prefer array list if you have more number of retrieving operations. Okay, that is the concept. Now, when we need to go for array list, when you go for linked list. So what about the linked list? So linked list, we can prefer if you have more number of insertions and deletions. So linked list you can prefer when you have more number of insertion deletions, because here there is no shifting place, but it takes place. So insertion and deletion will not take much time here. So but whenever you have a more number of retrieving operations, then go for array list, don't go for linked list. So I'll tell you why. So why we should go for linked list. If you have more number of insertion and deletion, why we should prefer linked list. If you have more number of retrieving operations, we should not prefer the linked list. So why is that? So let me just give you one example here. So when we have to prefer linked list. So if I just look at how the linked list elements will be stored in the memory. In case of array list, all the objects or element will be stored in the consecutive order. So let's say 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. But in case of linked list, element will not be stored in the consecutive order. So wherever the memory locations are there, so all the elements will be stored in the randomly, and each and every element will be linked together. So with the address. So we'll see how the linked list will be organized with the different elements. So for example, so when I say linked list, let's say I have multiple. So in the linked list, we use a terminology called as a node. Every element or object is called as a node. So for example, let's say I have one element here, and I have one more element here, and I have one more element here. So three nodes I have. This is my first node. So every node is divided into three parts. So in the middle part, we have exact object or element. Now the first and second part we have. So the first part is representing the previous element address. Suppose if there is any previous element before that, so that address will be there. So this is zero element, first element, second element. Here index is also there. Index will be maintained. Suppose X is a first element. If there is no before this, there is no element. So this is basically null. And after X, there is one more element called Y. So here, this is exactly pointing to the Y. So here, the next element address and the first position, previous element address. So next, and this is the next element address. This is the previous element address. Similarly, Y is also, this is also one more node or element. So here also, the first position, previous element, and the next element address. And here also, previous element, and next element address. So next element, there is no element, so this is a null. So this is how the data will be stored in the form of nodes in the linked list. So these are first element, second element, and third element. Every element is representing with index number 0, 1, and 2. So every node is having three parts. First part is representing the previous element address. The second part is having element. The third part is representing the address of the next element. So this is how the linked list will be organized. Now, suppose here I want to perform insert operation, or I want to perform delete operation, or I want to perform retrieve operation. So which one is feasible here? So let us see. Suppose I want to add a new element or a new object in the linked list. So this is all linked list. Okay. So I want to add a new element inside the linked list. So where I want to add. So for example, let's say, so I have a method like this. So linked list, let's say L dot add. I can pass some index number. Let's say in the first position, I just add some element called A. Right, so in the first position I want to add element called A, or object is A. Now how it is going to insert this element inside the linked list? So it should add here, right? So in this case, in the first position, currently this element is there. Now it should be there. So this element should be first. So now what happens is, this will remove this link, okay, and this will point to this. So this is a one more node. It will create a new node. This is let me just write it here. So it is like this. So previously it is linked with the next node, okay. So now what happens is, whenever you add a new element here, it will create a new node, and again it is having two parts. This is A. Now the first element is linked with the second element here previously. Now the link will be changed to this element, and like this. So now the link is changed. So as soon as I added a new element, and for these two elements we have not shifted, so still they are in the same position. But as soon as we have added a new element, now what happens in the new element, the previous node address will be here and the next node address will be here. So now it is 0, this is become 1, this is become 2, this is become 3. So the nodes are in the same place, but we have added a new element, a new node in the middle of 0 and 2, and then it will become the first element. So this is how the insertion will be happen inside the linked list. Suppose I want to add I want to delete some element. So I'll say L dot delete, and which one we have to delete? Some index number I can pass. So suppose I'll say I'll pass 2. So when I pass a 2 as an index, so which element should be deleted? This element should be deleted. So when I delete this element, now what happens is, when I apply the delete operation, so this link will be disconnected, and this element will be pointed to the next element, and this link is also deleted, and this is pointing to this one, like this. So now if I take this element, the previous element is this one, for this the next element is this one, but this is element is applicable for garbage collection. So this is how the deletion operation will happen in the linked list. So when I do insertion or deletion, right, or addition, so in these operations we are not shifting any elements in the linked list, but we are adding or we are deleting the nodes in the middle of somewhere. So when I do these operations, there is no shifting takes place, so it will go very faster. But in case of array list, the all the elements should be shifted to the next positions, but here only this link will be disconnected, okay. So that's the reason, whenever you have insertion operations or deletion operations, you will go with the linked list concept. But when we should not prefer this concept, linked list is also having some limitation. But when we should not prefer the linked list concept, we should not prefer the linked list concept if you have more number of retrievals. So why is that so? So let me just show you with some example. So why we should not prefer linked list if you have more number of retrieval operations. So here I have that element. Let's say I have first element. Observe this carefully. So this is my x, this is my null, because we don't have a previous node here. This is a null, and I have one more element, and let's say this is my y, and this is pointing to this, and this is pointing to this, and I have x, y, and I have one more element called z. This is pointing to this, and there is no next element, okay. So for example, let's say I want to retrieve some node or element from the linked list. So for example, I want to retrieve this element, or I want to retrieve the first element, for example. So how we can retrieve? When I say get of and index number, let's say this is 0, 1 and 2. So when I say 0, it will go to this element, right? So directly it will give you that element. So when I access the first element, it will go very fast. Let us assume this will take 1 second of time, okay. Now I want to retrieve the third element. I say get of 0, 1 and 2. So I say get of 2. Now what happens? I want to retrieve this element, but in the linked list it cannot directly get that element. So now what happens is, before getting this element, where exactly this element is present? This element address is present here, and it will go here, right? Here it will refer. And where this element is present? Here. So the address is present here, so it will go to the previous node. So whenever you want to search for any element, or whenever you want to get that element, addresses will be starting from the first node itself. So first it will go here, get the next address, then go with the next node, get another address, go to the next node, and whenever it find here, that element will be retrieved. So suppose I have 100 nodes like this, and if you are trying to retrieve the 100th element, so how many navigations it is required? Almost 99 nodes it should refer, and then only we will get the 100, because 100th node is address is present in the 99th node is the address is present inside the 98, 99th address is present inside the 97, and so on. It will come till 1, right? So to get this element, it should navigate through all the nodes and finally we'll get that element. So that's the reason it will take a lot of time to retrieve the data from the linked list. So that's the reason we should not prefer the linked list concept whenever you have more number of retrieving operations in your collections. So with this, what we have understood so far is two things we have discussed. One is we have insertion and deletion, and the second one is we have retrieving of elements, right? If you have more number of insertion and deletion, which one you have to prefer? Linked list. Okay, linked list we have to prefer. So let me just write it like this. So here I'll say linked list and array list. So when I say like this, so when you have to prefer, if you have more number of insertions and deletions, then which we have to prefer? Linked list is preferred, array list is not preferred. And when you have a retrieving operations, more number of retrieving operations, then array list is preferred, linked list is not preferred. So this we have to be understand as a first step. Now, so once we have understood when we have to use linked list, then let us see what are all methods available inside the linked list and how we need to work with those methods. And as I said before, right, so we have a collection interface, and a collection interface again extended to list interface. List interface is extended to array list and a linked list. So this flow we know, so linked list. So collection interface is extended to list interface, and again list interface is implemented by using array list class and linked list class. So whatever methods are available in the list interface, the same methods are also available in the linked list. So list interface methods are also available in the linked list. So similarly, array list is also implemented same method from the list interface. So whatever methods we have discussed in the array list class, the same number of methods are available in the linked list also. The same methods works in the linked list also. Apart from this, it is also implemented some more methods from the DQ interface. DQ interface, right? So those methods are also implemented here. So most of the times linked list will be preferred to develop the stacks and queues. So for that, linked list will be most of the times will be used. So linked list is also having some additional methods like adding elements, deleting elements, okay, and getting that element from the linked list. So apart from the normal methods, there are also some additional or linked list specific methods also available, because most of the times we use this linked list to work with the stacks and queues. And especially the linked list is also implemented method from the DQ interface. So whenever you do some operations on the stacks and queues, we need a special methods, and those methods are also available inside the linked list. So linked list most of the times we use to implement the stacks and queues. So what is the stack here means? So what is a stack? Stack means suppose we have multiple elements like this. So I put some elements like this, first in, last out, first in, last out. So this is a basically stack principle. So whichever element we'll first put inside, that element will be there, and first in and first out. First in and first out is a basically stack concept. Okay, first in and first out. So whichever element will first inside, so that will go here, next element go here, next element this element. So when I pull that element, which element will come? So the last element will come first. So first element, first in, first out is a basically queue concept. Okay, first in, last out is a stack concept. So whichever element we inserted here, if I get that element first, this is a queue concept. And whichever element we have inserted, that element will get the last, that is a again a stack concept. So these two concepts have implemented by using different methods inside the linked list. So that's the reason linked list is also having a separate methods which are specific to linked list, and we are going to discuss those methods along with the normal methods which are implemented from the list interface. Okay, so this is a concept of linked list. So in the linked list, so if I just come to the conclusion of linked list, what we have understood here is, so linked list is also a class which is implemented methods from the list interface, list is interface, and also DQ interface. So these interface methods are implemented inside the linked list, and linked list is allow the duplicates. So we can have a duplicate values, and also insertion order is preserved. Insertion order is also preserved, and we can also insert a nulls. Nulls are also acceptable. So these three properties are there in the array list also. In array list also, duplicates element are allowed, insertion order is preserved, and null values are also allowed. In the same way, linked list is also duplicate elements are allowed, insertion is order is present preserved, and nulls also available. But in case of array list, all the elements will be aligned in the consecutive order, one after another. The memory location will be located. Let's 1, 2, 3, 0, something like this. But in case of a linked list, there is no consecutive values. Some element will be there, some element will be another location, some other element will be some other location. But these elements internally linked with the addresses of those elements. Like every node is having previous address, previous element address, and next element address, previous element address, and next element address. So by those addresses, it will connect each other. So by default, the linked list will follow the doubly linked list. So I'll say doubly linked list data structure. So as I said beginning, every collection is implemented based on some underlying data structure, right? Similarly, linked list is also implemented based on the doubly linked list data structure. So this is all about what is linked list, and linked list allow the duplicates, insertion order is preserved, nulls also accepted. Every node in the linked list is having three parts. One part is having previous element address, the value, plus the next element address. And insertion and deletion operations will be easy in the linked list. But when you have to prefer the linked list, if you have more number of insertion and deletions, then we have to prefer the linked list. But if you have more number of retrievals, then we should not prefer the linked list, because it will navigate throughout the nodes to get those elements. So that is the reason we should not prefer this linked list if you have more number of retrieving operations. So now we will discuss what are all methods are available in the linked list. So what are all methods available inside the linked list class? So in the previous session, we have discussed about all array list methods. So the same methods are available in the linked list also, but additionally, we have separate methods. So now I'll show you what are the other methods are available inside the linked list. So let us say I have different elements. Let us say these are the different elements. I have a linked list X, Y, Z, and some A like this. So every element is connected with the previous and next element addresses. So what are the methods are available? So general methods which are coming from the list interface are, let's say add method is available. Add. Okay, so when I say directly object, so that element will be added at the end of the linked list. Suppose if you want to add or insert element in the middle of the array list, so middle of the linked list, I'll say add, index we have to pass, and then object or element we have to specify. So add method with object, add method with index along with the object we can use. So this is basically insertion. Okay, these methods are there. And we also have add all method, add all. So here we can specify one collection, any collection. So what this method will do is, suppose I have another collection, like it can be array list or linked list, whatever it is, I want to add a group of elements inside the linked list, I can use add method. So add with the object, add with the index object, add all with the collection. Similarly, we also have method called remove, and here I can specify element or object, it will directly go and remove the object. And also we have remove with index, we can pass the index, and along with the index it will go and get that node and it will remove that element. And we also have remove all. So we say collection, so whatever the collection elements we have specified, those elements will be removed from the linked list. So these are the common methods we have. Suppose I want to retrieve the node from the linked list, we also have get method. So linked list object dot get of, we can specify the index, and accordingly it will get that particular node or object from the linked list. And suppose I want to replace that element, I have a method called linked list dot set, and here we have to pass a index comma object or element. So this will set method will replace the existing value or change the existing value in the same node. So these are the generic methods we have in the linked list. And apart from this, if you want to perform any sortings and shufflings, again we can go with the collections dot utility methods. Yesterday also we have discussed about if you want to perform some operations on the collections like sortings and shufflings, we don't have a direct methods available in this collection, so we use a special class called collections class, which is also available in the java.util class, and which contains methods called sort and shuffle. So by using these methods we can sort the elements in the linked list and we can shuffle the elements in the linked list. So these methods are also available along with these methods. So these are all methods implemented from the list interface. Even ArrayList is also having the same methods. But now when you come to the linked list, what are the special methods are available which are related to linked list, especially those methods we use while implementing the stacks and the queues. So now we will discuss those methods. So what are the linked list specific methods are available? So there are linked list specific methods are available. For example, let's say I have multiple elements in the linked list like this, let's say x, y and z and so on. So here basically what is a stack and a queue means? So we say multiple elements we'll put. So as soon as we put some element, that element come here, and next element, and next element, next element. So whichever element first comes, that will come last. So first in, first out. So whichever the first element we have here, that will come last. First in, last out. So this is a stack. So what is the queue here? So for example, if I put one element here, it will go here and that element will come first. So this is a first in, first out. This is a queue concept. So these two concepts we will implement by using a linked list concept. So linked list class we can use to implement the stack and the queues. So to do different operations on this, we have a special method like, so the first method we have is add first. Add first is a method. So this particular method will add an object in the first, either in stack or queue, whatever. So it will add this object in the first in the linked list. So let me just show you here. So I have a linked list which contains multiple elements. So let us see here. So I have multiple elements. So one first element, second element, let's say third element, fourth element. And those elements are linked together, right? So these are the elements. So zero element, first element, second and third element. Now add first is a method. So what add first method will do is it will add a new object in the first position here. This will become 0, this will become 1 and 2, 3 and 4. So the new element will be added here. The add first means that object will be added in the first element as a first node in the linked list. And there is one more method called add last. When I say object here, that element will be added at the end of the linked list. So here it will add the new element, the last element. Add last and add first. And similarly, we also have remove first and remove last. Remove first element. So when I say this remove first, the first element will be removed from the linked list. And I'll say remove last. When I say remove last, so this method will remove the last element or last node from the linked list. And apart from this, we also have get first. Get first. So this particular method will get the first element or first node from the linked list. And we have one more method called get last. So this particular method will get you the last element or last node from the linked list. Okay, so these are all special methods which we have, which are specific to linked list class. Okay, so whenever you're working with the linked list objects, we can also use this method. Whenever you're implementing like stack and queues, then we can use these methods. Okay, so these are all different methods which are available inside the linked list. So after discussion of all these methods, now we have understood what is linked list, when we have to prefer the linked list, and what are the methods are available in the linked list, which are comes from the list interface, and what are additional methods are implemented in the linked list, which are comes from the DQ interface. So apart from this, we will see now how we can use all the methods practically. Okay, so now let us move on to the demo part. Okay, so now I'll show you how we can use a different methods in the linked list. So we already created a new Java collections project in the my previous video. So already collections demo package is there. Inside this, I'm just going to create a new class to demonstrate linked list methods. So here I'll say linked list demo one. Let's take a main method and then say finish. Okay, so now here I'll just create linked list. How to create a linked list object? So how we can declare a linked list? So to declare a linked list, we have a many ways. So normally, if we want to store heterogeneous of data or heterogeneous data in the linked list, normally linked list will allow us to store heterogeneous data. So for that, I can say linked list l equal to new linked list. I can define like this, new linked list. So this linked list is a class which is available inside the java.util package. So which I have to import this. So this is a generic way we create a linked list object, and L is a reference variable. Now this will this linked list allow us to store heterogeneous data. And suppose I want to restrict this with homogeneous data, I can just define the type. I'll say linked list. Say a linked list L equal to new linked list, right? So now we have to specify the type here. Suppose I want to store only numbers, I'll say integer. There is a wrapper class of number. And same thing we have to specify here in the angular brackets. And this will allow us to store only numbers. So similarly, if you want to store some strings, I can simply say, I'll say a string here. And here also I can say string. So any wrapper class you can specify here. So this is how we can just restrict, or we can store only homogeneous data. If you want to store in the linked list, we can use this notation. So for now, I'm just using this part, this one. So to store heterogeneous data. And now I created one array list, linked list L equal to new linked list. So now I want to add some elements or objects into the linked list. How to add elements into linked list? So to add elements into linked list, we have a method called add. I'll say l dot, l is a reference variable of linked list, and l dot I'll say add, and here I can pass some value, let's say 100. And similarly, I'll try to pass some heterogeneous data. I'll say here I'll pass a string data, and here I'll pass something called some decimal number, and here I'll just pass some character, and in the next element I will pass as a boolean value, and which will also allow us to store a null. So add true, and we can also store null. So null is also accepted in the array list, sorry, in the linked list. Okay, so now we have added multiple elements into the linked list. Suppose I want to print all of them, what I can say is simply I can say system.out.println. I can just print L. So L is a linked list variable. Now let us execute run as a Java application now, which will print all the data. So this is how we can add data into the linked list. And suppose I want to find size, like how many nodes or elements or objects are present inside the linked list. So for that, I can use a method called system.out.println l.size. So l.size is a method which will give you how many nodes we have added into the linked list. So here, one more thing is just like a array list, if you don't specify any number of locations, by default, 10 will be allocated. And later, if you keep on adding the new elements, automatically the size will be growable. But here, there is no limit like this. There is no default size like this, because it will internally maintain all the elements in the form of nodes. So there is no default location like this. So we can just add elements as many as possible. We can keep on increase the size. So here, l.size is a method which will give you how many objects are present inside the linked list. So currently there are 6 objects are present including null. And suppose I want to remove this object, some object from the linked list. So to remove that, I can use one more method called l.remove. You can use this method. And here you can just pass a index of the element. Suppose I want to remove something called, let's say I want to remove this element. This is 0, 1, 2, third element I want to remove. I'll say 3 here. So when I pass index, that will remove the element. Then after removing this element or object, I can print that value. I'll say system.out.println. And here I'll just say after removing new list, I'm just printing here plus L. Right, so now execute this and this will remove the element from this 3. So again, this is a new list. So now we can just look at here, the A is removed from this list. Previously A was there. So this is a list which is printed here. And this is the latest list after removing the element or node from the linked list. Again, insertion order is preserved here. In the same order, the elements will be inserted. Now, suppose I want to remove the element by passing the value. So here I pass an index. And we can also remove the element by passing the value directly. So L dot, we can pass the, I'll say remove. Directly we can pass the object name or the value. Suppose, and here itself I'll use instead of index, right? So instead of index, I can just use a value. Suppose I want to remove this value, I can directly pass it here. And this is also right. So when I run this, this will also remove the element. So here it is giving index out of bound exception. So why it is giving index out of bound exception? Now let us look at this. Okay, so now we can just pass only index. It is not allowing to pass the value. So by using index only, we can just remove the element from the linked list. Now, apart from this, suppose if you want to insert a new element, and insert add is a method, we can add a new value or new object at the end of the linked list. Suppose I want to add a new object in the middle of the linked list, then we can insert. So which is adding element in the middle of linked list. So in the middle of linked list. So how we can do that? So L dot, right? So L dot, I can simply say add, same method, add method. But here we have to specify index and value. Okay. So we can just choose this one. Index we have to specify. So here we have already removed the third element, right? So in the third position, so currently what is the element we have in the third position? This is 0, 1, 2 and 3. So we have a Boolean value. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. In the fourth location, we have a null. So I want to insert a new element somewhere here in the third position. So I'll say 3. And I'll say my element something like Java. So this is my object or a value which we want to insert in the third position. So after inserting this, I'm just printing the data once again. So let me just close this and I'll say system.out.println after inserting element. After inserting element, the new list is, I'm just printing the new list here. Right, so execute. Okay, now we got the new list here. So this is a new list after insertion. So initially we have these 6 values, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And here we have removed the third element. Third element means 0, 1, 2, 3. So A is removed. After removing A, this is the new list. And from this, we are inserting Java in third place. So which is the third place? 0, 1, 2, 3. So true is the third place. So now here the Java is inserted exactly in the third place. The rest of the elements still there. So 0, 1, 2, 3. In the third position, exactly Java is inserted. So if you want to insert a new element, we can just pass the index along with the value. And suppose I want to retrieve the value from the linked list. Retrieving the value or retrieving the object from the linked list. So for that, I say l.get is a method. So L dot get is a method. So I'll say index number we have to pass.
So here in the third position, we have inserted Java. So I'm just passing the third location here. So that will return the object or element that I'm printing here. I'll say system.out.println. Okay, now here I'll say l.getOf3. So this will return the element which is exactly in the third position. So let us execute. So here it is written Java. In the third position, we have a Java. So this is a way we can retrieve the element from the linked list by using get method. And suppose I want to replace a value. So currently we have this list of items in the linked list. Now I want to replace some value with a new value. So suppose I want to replace the null with some other new value. So how we can replace a value or change the value or change the element. In that case, I can say l.set method. And here we have to pass index. So the index of null is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 is my index. And here I want to put something called x, some other element. And after setting this value, changing the value, again, I am printing the list, of values. I'll say system.out.println. Here, after changing the value. So after changing the value, we put L. So L is representing a linked list. So let's execute once again. Yes, now we can see the last value, previously it was null. Now it is replaced with the X. So this is another element. So by using set method, we can change the any element in the linked list. And suppose I have few elements here. So this is the latest list we have, linked list. And now I want to fetch some object or element is present inside this linked list. So to fetch that value, we use contains method, just like an array list. So for example, l.contains, and here you can pass the value. So suppose I want to fetch Java is present or not. So I can just pass Java here, l.contains Java. And if this value is present inside this linked list, which will return true. If it is not present, return false. So this I'll print like this, system.out.println. So l.contains Java. And suppose when I say l.contains something else, let's say I'll say Python. So this is not present inside the linked list. So this should return true and the second one should return false. All right, now let us execute. Yes, so the first one is return true, the second one is return false. So contains is a method by which we can fetch that element or object is present inside the linked list or not. And similarly, we can also check our linked list is having values or not, whether it is empty or not. So for that, we can also use one more method called isEmpty, which will verify our linked list is empty or not. If it is empty, then it returns true. If it is not empty, then return false. So I can use linked list variable dot is empty. So this will return either true or false. I'll say system.out.println l.isEmpty. So if it is not currently empty, so it should return false now. So when I execute, this should return false here. So we can verify our linked list is empty or not, right? So apart from these methods, suppose I want to read all the objects or all the data from the linked list. So how we can read them? So to read the linked list data, so we can also have multiple methods. We can use a normal for loop, or we can just use enhanced for loop, like for each loop, or we can also do by using iterator method. So even in the array list also, we have seen three different ways to read the data from the array list. So similarly here also in the linked list also, we have a three different ways we can read the data from the linked list. Now I'll show you all of them. So first let us start with the normal for loop by using index. So here I'll put something called reading objects or elements from a linked list using for loop. First, let us start with a normal for loop by using index. So here I'll say for, and here I'll start from index 0. So index I equal to 0. I less than. So here we are starting index from 0, so we have to use less than. But how many elements we have in the array list, how we will know whether how many elements are in this linked list? I'll say L dot size. So that will give you exactly how many elements we have in the linked list. So because index is starting from zero, I'm just using less than. So minus one. So here I'll say I plus plus. Every time I'll increase the I value by one. And how to get that value now? I'll say system dot out dot println. So to get the value from a linked list, simply I say L dot get of I. That's it. So get is a method which will extract that value from the node, from the linked list. So only thing is we have to just pass the index. So here I is representing the index. So in every iteration, I'm passing the I value as an index. So which will get the value from the linked list. So now let us run this code, which will give you all the data which is present inside the linked list. So these are the values we got. And same thing we can also write by using for each loop. We can also read the data by using for each loop. Now let me show you that I commented this. Now I'll show you how to read the data or reading elements from linked list using for each loop. So for that, we don't need to use any index. What we have to do is just specify the linked list reference variable and get each and every element from this linked list, store that element in a variable. So I can just say E, which is representing some element variable. And what should be the type of this variable? Because if the linked list is having all same kind of data, then you can specify the data type here. Or if the linked list is having different type of data or different type of objects, then this variable should be object type. Then it should be able to hold all kinds of objects and data. Now I can just print the value of E here. So system.out.println, I'll just say E. So this will print all the data elements from the linked list. So now we got the same data here. Okay, so this is a one way to get all the data from the linked list. So we can also use iterator method. To extract the data from the linked list. So for that, what you have to do is we have to create iterator object. Let's say it equal to new reference variable. And here L dot, there is a method called iterator. L is a reference variable of linked list. Dot, there is a method called iterator. Okay, so this is a particular method which will read individual items, and the return type should be iterator. So we have to import this iterator from java.util. Now we should read all the data from this variable. It is a my variable, iterator variable. So I'll just say it while loop, and here I'll say it dot has next method. So this will verify if there is any next value. If there is a next value or next element, it should true. It should become true. And then condition is matching, and then it will print system.out.println. It just print the value. I'll say it dot next method I'm using. Just the next method. So what this next method will do is it will basically system.out.println will print the element. And as soon as it printed this element, it will automatically move to the next element. And then again, it will go up and check the next element is present or not. If it is present, then again, this statement will execute. Okay. So this is how we can just write a iterator method by which also we can get the data from the linked list. Now, let me just comment the first loop here and then execute this approach. Now execute run as Java application. So again, we got the same data. So these are the different ways we can read the data from the linked list by using a for loop with index, by using for each loop, and by using iterator method. So these are normal methods we have to work with the linked list. So apart from this, we can also use some more methods. Let me show you those methods. And suppose I want to copy some other collections into linked list collection. Right, so I want to remove multiple objects in the linked list, or I want to add multiple objects into the linked list, then how it is possible. So let me show you one more example for linked list. Let's create a new class. I'll say linked list demo 2. Linked list demo 2, I say main method and then finish. So this time I'm going to show you how we can add multiple objects or multiple elements into linked list. And the same way we can also remove the multiple element from the linked list. So just we have to use add all, remove all methods. Okay, so for that, before that, I'm just creating a linked list object. I'll say a linked list. Okay, and L equal to new linked list. Okay, so now I created one linked list object. And import this linked list java.util, and L is a reference variable of linked list. And this time I'm just storing homogeneous data so that I want to also show you how we can sort the elements. So sorting is possible only if you have a same kind of data or similar kind of object or similar type of data, then sorting shuffling is possible. Okay, so for that reason, I'm just storing homogeneous data. That means all same type of data in this linked list. So for that, I'll say l.add. For now, I'm just adding individual elements, single elements multiple times. So l.add, here I'll say x, this is the first element. And similarly, I'm trying to add more elements. I'll say x, y, and it is a z. I'll say this is a, and this is b, and here I'll say c. So now I'm adding all the string data in my linked list. So 3, 4, 5, 6 elements we have in the linked list. So now what I want to do is, so I want to add this linked list into some other linked list. I'll create some other linked list variable. So I want to just add a group of elements. Okay, so group of elements in the collection. So it is exactly like this. Suppose I have already some linked list which contains multiple elements here. So this is one linked list. So I'll create one more linked list. And now I want to add all the group of objects into this linked list. Okay, so how we can add them? So for that, I created one linked list here. So this is the one. So now I'm going to create one more linked list variable, and the whatever we already created, which contains some data, I'll add all the objects into the new linked list. Okay, so now let me show you how we can do that. So for that, what I'm going to do is I'll create another linked list. So for that, what I can do is I'll say linked list. Okay, I'll say linked list. Okay, so I'll say new underscore L. This is a new linked list equal to new linked list. Okay, now this is a new linked list reference variable. Now whatever the objects or elements are present inside my previous linked list, I want to add all of them into this new linked list. So for that, I'm just going to use add all method. So in this linked list, I want to add all. Here we have to say collection. This collection, linked list collection, we already have. Just specify that. So now whatever the elements we have in this linked list, the same elements are also available inside the new linked list. Now let us print them. System.out.println. And here I'll say new hyphen linked list. The same group of elements or group of objects we have add into the another linked list. So when I run this, which will give you the same elements. Like this, we can add a group of elements or group of objects into linked list. And by using add all method. And similarly, we also have a remove all method. If I use only remove method, we can just remove one object from the linked list. If you have remove all method, which will remove all the objects from the linked list. Now, this particular new underscore L, this is a linked list which contains all the data. Now I want to remove all of them. So for that, what I can do is I can use new underscore L, this is a new linked list we just created, new underscore L dot remove all. And which collection we have to remove? So L should be removed. So L means L contains these elements. So whatever elements we have in this L, all the elements or objects will be removed from this new underscore L. So new underscore L is also having some more elements, doesn't matter. But whatever the elements which are added from this linked list L, those elements will be removed. Now, so after remove this, again, I'll try to print this. So I'll just print the same thing here, and it should give empty list. So when I run this, it should give empty. So that means there are no objects in this linked list. So that's the way we can use add all and remove all. Add all is a method by which we can add multiple objects into the linked list, and remove all is another method by which we can remove multiple objects from the linked list. So apart from this, we can also do something called sorting and shuffling. So to do this, we have to use utility method from the collections class. All right. So collections is a separate class which is also available inside the util package, java.util package. And in that class, there are certain methods like sort and shuffling. So by using those methods, we can sort the objects or elements inside the linked list. Now I'm just going to show you how to use sort, especially for sorting. So the syntax of this sort is, I'll say collections class dot sort method. And here we have to specify the collection type, and this will sort those elements. Okay, now let us try to use this method for linked list. So currently L is having all this data. So here we have removed the elements from the new underscore linked list. This is the new linked list. So, but the old linked list, whichever we created, still these elements are present. So now I want to sort them. So before that, I'm just trying to print system.out.println, and here say before sorting, I just print those values, let's say L. Okay, so before sorting. Now after that, I'll say collections dot sort of L. So this is the method, guys, collection dot sort. Okay, and here I'll say L. So this particular method will sort the elements which are present inside the linked list. So after sorting is happened, then again I'll print the linked list item. So this is after sorting. Now let us execute. So run as Java application. Now these are the elements before sorting and these are the elements after sorting. So it is exactly aligned in the alphabetical order, ABC and XYZ. And similarly, if you want to arrange this in the reverse order, and if you want to sort in the reverse order, you can still do that. So for that, what you can do is simply, currently these are the elements we have here, and these are the elements currently we have here. Okay, so after sorting, this is the latest linked list items. Now A, B, C, X, Y, Z. So now these are all in descending order. Now I want to assign them in the reverse order. I want to assign these elements in the reverse order. So in that case, I can use one more method. So I want to just say reverse order. For that, I'll say there is one more method called collections.sort, the same method we have to use, but here we can specify which collection you want to sort, that is L, comma, the reverse order I want to sort. So for that, we have to use one more method called collections.reverseOrder, and just close this. So this particular command will close, reverse the elements which are present inside the linked list. Now I'll just print the elements after arranging in the reverse order. So I can just say sysout, and here I'll just print, this is a reverse order. So reverse order. So here I'll just say print L. So this particular method will reverse the collection elements. Now execute. So this will give you, so this is giving some syntax error. So we forgot to put the semicolon here. All right, so now execute one more time. So here, this is a reverse order. So this is after sorting, these are the ascending order. Now it is giving the descending order. And the sortings are possible only if you have a same kind of data. Okay, if you have only homogeneous data. All right, so this is how we can just sort the elements inside the linked list. So if you want to do shuffling, we can also do shuffling. For that also, we have a method in the collections. So for that, what you have to do is, I say collections.shuffle, and here we have to just pass the collection name, that is our linked list reference variable. And this will shuffle our elements inside the linked list, and after shuffling, I'm just printing the data once again, system.out.println, and here I'll just print L. So the data is shuffled. I'll just painting that data. That's a paintl. Okay, it just paint the next line. So now execute. So now this is a data after shuffling. So this is a data after shuffling. So let me just run one more time. Run as Java application. So now this is the data we have after shuffling. So randomly it will align all the data, all the elements in the linked list. Okay, so these are all common methods which we can use for linked list, and the same methods we have for array list also. Okay, but in addition, for especially for linked list, especially to do like stack and queue operations, we have a specific methods are available for the linked list. So now I'm going to show you what are those specific methods which are available for the linked list. Now let me just create one more example to demonstrate the special methods in the linked list, specific methods for linked list. Okay, so I'll say linked list demo 3. Just take a main method and say finish. Okay, so now I'm just going to show you a specific method, linked list specific methods here. And these methods especially we use to implementing stack and queue operations. And say first step, I'm just creating a linked list variable. I'll say linked list. Okay, linked list, and I'll say L equal to new linked list. So now I'm just importing this linked list from the java.util package. So now I'm just going to add some elements or objects into this linked list, and which method we have to use, l.add. This is a common method we use. So here I'm just going to add some animals. Let's say dog is my first element, and we can also have a duplicate elements, right? So duplicate elements also we can have. So here I'll say one more element is cat. I'll say one more element is, let's say, okay, I'll say horse. Okay, so duplicate elements also allowed in the linked list. So now I have a 4 elements which I have added into the linked list. Now let us print them. Say system.out.println. I'll just print the linked list elements. So when I run this, which will print all the elements which are present inside the linked list. Okay, now I'm just going to show you specific methods which are related to linked list. So the first method is add first. Suppose these are the elements. These are 0, 1, 2, 3. So I want to add a new element in the first node, as a first node in the linked list. Okay, as a first node. And because insertion order is preserved here. So first two elements are dog, cat, and horse. So I want to insert or a new element at the first position of the linked list. So I can say L dot add first. This is a method. And which one you have to add? So here just I want to add something called tiger. So this particular node will be added in the first position of your linked list. And similarly, I want to add a new element or new object at the end of the linked list. So at the end of the linked list. So we also have one more method, add last. This is a method. And here I just want to add one more element. I'll say elephant. Okay, so I'm adding this element in the first in the linked list as a first element in the linked list. And this element is going to add as a last element in the linked list or last object in the linked list. So after adding these two, first and last, then again, I'm printing linked list. I'll say system.out.println. I just say linked list variable name. So now let us execute. So now we can see here, before that linked list is having only 4 elements. Now tiger is added as a first element and element is added as a last element inside the linked list. So this is a latest list after adding first and last elements. Now I want to get the first element and then I want to get the last element. I want to extract the first and last elements. And if you want to get any element, we can just pass the index, then it will give you a method. We can use get method directly. So L dot get of, if I pass an index, that will give you the value which is present in that particular index or location. But especially I want to get the first element and the last element from this linked list. So then you can use get first and get last methods. Okay. So L dot get first. So this is a method. So which will return the first element in the linked list. So let me say system dot out dot println L dot get first. Okay. Now this is a println. All right, so this is a get first, and also let me use get last method. Get last method. So these two methods, the get first method will give you the first element, get last method will give you the last element. Now let us run this. Now you can see this is a tiger is the first element we have in the linked list, and elephant is the last element which we have in the linked list. So suppose I want to remove the first element and last element. So we have seen how to add a first element, last element, how to get first element and last element. Now I'm going to show you how to remove the first element and last element. Suppose if you want to remove any element, you can just use a remove method along with the index, and whichever index you pass, that element will be removed from the linked list. But here there are specific method we have to remove the first element and last element. So for that you can just use remove first and remove last. So I'll say L dot remove first. Okay, this will remove the first element. Again, L dot remove last. So this will remove the last element. So after removing, again I'm printing the element. So I'll say system dot out dot println. I'll just print L after removing first and last elements. Okay, so here I'll print. After removing first and last elements, that's it. Okay, so now let us run this, which will give you, so this is a list of elements after removing first and last elements. Okay, so these are the specific methods we have for linked list. So like add first and add last, get first and get last, and remove first and remove last. So these are the specific methods which we have for the linked list. Okay, so now we have seen how we can work with the linked list. What is a linked list? What are the different methods are available in the linked list, and what are the different type of operations we can do in the linked list by using a different methods. Okay, so in the next session we will see in some other collection in Java. Okay, so thanks for watching, guys.